What do baking cookies using grandma's secret recipe and life science have in common? Well, more than you might think. Just like creating perfect, mouth-watering goodness requires many steps and attention to detail, the process of creating resources in our cells requires a similar set of steps and careful execution. Luckily for us, our cells have developed a really cool process called protein synthesis to help us out. In today's lesson, we'll explore this topic as we describe the steps of protein synthesis, explain the importance of RNA in this process, and evaluate how protein synthesis is important to living things. Let's get into it! In our previous lesson, we learned how DNA stores information in our cells. We now know that DNA is an incredibly complex structure that can have billions of nitrogen bases, and the order of these nitrogen bases determines how cells operate. But how does this code actually determine what cells do? The secret lies in proteins. If we don't count water and fat, the human body is made almost entirely out of protein. And I'm not talking about just your muscles. Your hair, nails, tendon, the collagen that holds your skin together, and even the living parts of your bones are all made out of protein. In other words, proteins are what primarily determine the structure of living things. If we're looking at the difference between a lion and a zebra, or just the difference between two people, it is the makeup and arrangement of proteins that account for the vast majority of physical differences. Proteins are made out of building blocks called amino acids. These amino acids have to be put together and folded in just the right way to make different kinds of proteins. If you'll recall from our lesson on cell structure, ribosomes are where proteins are made in the cell. But how do ribosomes know which amino acids to put together in what order to make the proteins cells need? Enter protein synthesis. Protein synthesis is the process by which proteins are built in cells. Synthesis means put together. So protein synthesis simply means to put together proteins. There are two main steps in protein synthesis, the first of which is called transcription. Transcription is the process by which DNA from the nucleus is copied into RNA. RNA, or ribonucleic acid, is similar to DNA, but it is single-stranded and contains the nitrogen-based uracil instead of thiamine. There are multiple kinds of RNA with specialized jobs, and mRNA, or messenger RNA, is responsible for transcription. Now, you might be thinking, what do we need mRNA for if we have DNA? Doesn't this seem like an unnecessary step? Well, DNA never leaves the nucleus. Remember, DNA is incredibly complex. So you can think of the nucleus as a vault that keeps all of the cells' valuable information safe and organized. Since DNA can't leave, mRNA's job is to act as a middleman, copying code directly from the DNA in the nucleus and bringing it to the ribosomes. If we're talking about baking cookies, transcription is the part of our venture where we open Grandma's vault and copy down her super secret recipe. We don't just steal the recipe directly out of her secret vault, because then it might get lost, or worse, she'd find out. Instead, we copy it so that she'll never know we borrowed it. This is what mRNA do during transcription. They make a copy of code from DNA so the ribosomes know what proteins to synthesize. The second major step of protein synthesis is translation. Translation is the process by which ribosomes read mRNA in order to build proteins. You can think of this as translating all those nitrogen bases into an actual protein that cells can use. mRNA is divided into codons. Each codon, which consists of three nitrogen bases, codes for one amino acid. As you recall, amino acids are the building blocks of proteins. mRNA feeds through ribosomes almost like a zipper, and ribosomes read the RNA one codon at a time, adding the required amino acid to the protein before translating the next codon. Another type of RNA called tRNA or transfer RNA helps with this process. Ribosomes continue to do this until a codon tells them to stop, in which case they will release the finished protein, ending the translation process. From here, the protein is typically sent to the Golgi apparatus, or post office of the cell, where it is packaged and sent out to become a hard-working molecular citizen of your body. If we're talking about baking cookies, translation is the part of the process where we translate our recipe into actual cookies, taking ink on a page and turning that information into physical cookies that we can eat and enjoy. Additionally, it's important to understand that this process does not happen all by itself. Just like you can't bake grandma's delicious cookie recipe if you don't have ingredients like flour and sugar handy, your cells can't build proteins out of nothing. The amino acids and other resources we need to make our proteins come from cellular transport and cellular metabolism, which in turn also require proteins to function and rely on protein synthesis. All of these cellular processes work together in harmony to help you maintain your personal homeostasis, or balance, in your body. And as long as you're alive, this cellular hustle never stops. Just like cells wear out over time and require the cell cycle to replace them, proteins wear out as well and require protein synthesis to replenish the supply. Exposure to heat and certain chemicals causes them to denature or lose their shape. When this happens, proteins can no longer function properly, so our cells have to replace them by making more. You can observe protein synthesis affecting your life when your hair or nails grow, when you use your muscles, or even when you feel hungry, because many of the chemical messengers in your body are also made of proteins. Without protein synthesis, our cells wouldn't be able to build what they need to function and keep us healthy. So, next time you lose some hair to the shower drain or clip your nails, think about all of the trips RNA had to make in your cells to make those protein structures possible. All right, we've now covered the basics of protein synthesis. In this lesson, we've learned that proteins have many important functions in the body and are built out of smaller parts called amino acids. Protein synthesis is the process by which cells build proteins out of these amino acids, and there are two main steps. The first is transcription, which is when DNA is copied into mRNA, and the second is translation, when mRNA is used by ribosomes to assemble amino acids into a functioning protein. Protein synthesis is happening constantly to replace damaged proteins and help living things maintain homeostasis. In our next lesson, we'll dive into the field of genetics as we take a closer look at how DNA and protein synthesis express specific traits in living things. Until then, I'm Caroline, and remember, life is full of wonders. So keep learning and don't ever stop wondering. Hey.